There are more than 10,000 black market organ transplants around the world every year. That is more than one an hour. And desperate Australians are among those fueling the demand.
In the crowded slums of the Philippines' capital, Manila, the illegal trade in human organs is an open secret.
It is poverty that drives these people to sell their kidneys.
I don't have any means of getting money for my family, so I decided to sell my kidney.
I have a visitor from Australia. They need kidney. They talk to me. I like you. Yeah. Please donate your organ.
Roger Bellacoco is an organ broker, and in just 2 years, he traded more than 300 kidneys.
I have also have friends. He donated his eyes. It's 300,000. Yeah. Then he buy a ice cream rolling store.
Supplying the trade are hundreds of donors, like 33-year-old Genesis Labiana.
We needed money to repair our house because we are a broken family.
For the equivalent of $1 a day, he boils and sells corn to tourists. But for a cash payment of nearly $3,000, he was lured by an Australian into a much more sinister trade.
I heard from a relative that he was able to sell his kidney to a foreigner. So I decided to present myself because it is huge money.
Both his surgeon and an organ broker told him a middle-aged Australian woman would get his kidney, and without it, she would die within weeks.
In the emergency room, I actually turned my head and looked at her. She even smiled at me.
Seeing him in hospital brought his mum to tears.
It's very difficult. I even cried seeing my boy, looking at him in the hospital, and I really got scared.
It was then that she too fell into the organ trade.
And then the doctor approached me and asked me if I want to get more people to be involved in giving up their kidneys.
As a broker, the 53-year-old set up 20 organ transplants until a deal turned sour and her luck ran out.
When I was asking money from the patient, they held me at gunpoint, even my husband, and so I decided that it's not really worth my life getting that money.
Tough new laws forbidding the trade of organs to foreigners have virtually stamped out so-called transplant tourism.
In slums like these, where the organ trade was once rampant, it's easy to see why the idea is almost impossible to resist. These shacks, these homes, are made entirely from garbage and scraps washed up from sea, and desperate foreigners are offering them a way out, a four-hour operation that can forever change their lives.
The fear now is that the crackdown on the organ trade is forcing desperately sick Westerners into human trafficking. Our first case of organ harvesting involved an elderly Australian who offered a Filipino woman $20,000 for her kidney. But the scheme was uncovered last year during the screening process at a Sydney hospital, and the surgery was cancelled.
It is happening because Australians can't afford to pay. $20,000 is a lot of money that you can buy a house and lot, you can start a business. And so from their point of view, we survive with one kidney, why not?
Despite the cash incentive, Rogers turned down recent offers from four Australians wanting to buy his kidney.
You sell your one of your parts, I think the God don't like.
I think it is okay for us to pursue it because it is able to help us extend another's life. So I'm happy with my decision. I have no regrets. When I was a young
boy. Oh, that's a full-on story. Matt, what do you know about the guy who sold his eyes?
Yeah, that was quite a heartbreaking story. That gentleman who decided to sell his eyes to buy a milk cart for his family, and the concept of money to these people, these donors, they come from such a place of extreme poverty that they had no idea how to use it. He was broke, and the milk cart effectively useless within 6 months.
Oh, wow. And I bet you that's a common tale as well.
It is indeed.
But you said there that the new laws had stamped it out over there. So what's the concern now?
Well, look, you're right. This whole idea of the the phenomenon, I suppose, of these black market transplants is not new. What is new and what is concerning federal legislators here to such an extent that they've now moved to rush urgent laws through Parliament is this idea of foreigners going over to these donor-rich environments, seeking out these sorts of people and bringing them back to Australia for transplants here. It has only happened the once that we know of now, but anecdotally on the ground over there, it is something that is happening more and more often.
Well, we'll put a link up at theprojecttv.com.au with more information on the fight against human trafficking. Time for us to take a break now. We'll see you in a moment.